Hello friends, welcome to KB Tutorials. So in this tutorial, I am going to show you how we can print the response of REST API to the console. So it is really important that we get control over the response of an API so that we can perform more validations very easily. So as you can see here, this is my API guys. And if you observe it, this API is returning me this response. Let me try to show the response as well. So if I hit this response, if I hit this API, I'm going to get this response. Okay, but how can I print this response in my test case so that I can perform multiple validations easily? So if you see here, this is my this is a one test case I have. Let me try to run this and show you how we are printing in the DOM. Then we'll see how we can implement it from the scratch. So as you can see, it started running and I think now it hit the API. Now we got the data. Just go to the console. Now you could see this is a response that we got. Right. Just let me put into the notepad and show you. Now you could see we got this one, right? So this object, we have set everything here. I hope you have set your post your API here, I mean your REST API here. So once you have this, you just create one test case. Let's say like here, create a test case. Let's say response printing is my test case. So here I'm doing send request, and which API I'm hitting? I'm hitting my post API, this one, post request. So I can select from here, or I can simply drag and drop. Okay, and let me try to assign it to some value. Let's say like response. If you go here to the console here, if you simply print this system.out.println or system.print up to your wish. If you print this, it will not going to print anything. I'm just showing you that it will not going to print anything here. So there's a small method that we need to learn. Now you could see it is completed execution, but is it print anything? So guys, if we print here, we are not getting any response, right? So here there's a small method that we need to use. So it is like response.get. Response text is a method guys. So this method, you assign it to some variable, let's say like data, and try to print it here. Get response text. This is send request. Here I'm using get response text as a method. Let's see how it is coming. Now you could see it is execution is completed. Now you could see we got the data, right? So let me take that. Get response text is our method, yes. Now you could see we got everything, right? So this is a very, very small method. Just take the response of send request and use a method called get response text and send it to the some variable and print that. I hope it's informative for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.